Hi everyone, welcome to the VSDC channel. In today's tutorial, we are diving into the new algorithm for creating transitions introduced in our latest update VSDC 9.1. Haven't upgraded yet? You'll find the link right in the description below. So let's get started. Previously, we used to create transitions by overlapping files across different layers and manually adding transition effects. While this traditional method is still available, 9.1 introduces an innovative approach. Overlaying files on a single layer, where intersections automatically create a transition area. We're going to explore several methods for creating these intersections, so let's take a closer look at each of them. Method 1. Start by pressing and holding the Alt key. Then, click and drag one file over another one on the timeline. You'll see a white line at the intersection indicating the area of transition. By default, a fade transition is applied, where the left file gradually fades out to reveal the right file. The downside here is that you lose the duration of your video by shifting one of the files. To avoid this, we have two more methods that focus on the video's border adjustments. Method 2. Again, press and hold the Alt key. But this time, adjust the edge of the file to create a transition. You might notice a marker on the right side of the file indicating a freeze frame. A great tip to maintain your video's duration is to slow down the playback. To do this, select the video and choose Play Entire Video in the Loop Mode section in the Properties. The marker will vanish, and the video will slow down to match the new duration. For those interested in adjusting video speed, here is a link in the top right corner. Method 3. This time, press and hold both the Alt and the Shift keys, then adjust the file's border. A transition will also be created, but the right frame of the video remains unchanged. Note that this method doesn't work with the original untrimmed file, as the software requires extra frames to create a transition area. Transition duration. Once you've created your transition area, you can adjust its duration by moving the video's border. Remember to be mindful of whether or not to hold down the Shift key during this process, as it affects whether the frames or just the trim border move. Without Shift, the video frames will move and a red marker will appear. Add in transition effects. Now, let's add some flair with transition effects. For this, access the Templates window. If it is closed, you can find it on the ribbon on the View tab. You can also open the Template Preview window to view the templates. Here you'll find two sections, Transitions and Transition Collection. You can drag and drop any transition from these sections onto the previously created transition area on the timeline. For a quick demonstration, let's choose a transition from the Mosaic folder and apply it to the highlighted area on the timeline. As a result, the fade transition is replaced by a newly selected one. To add multiple transitions at once, select all but the last file, then drag a transition from the Templates window to the scene. This method ensures that the last transition remains unaffected, unless both files involved in the transition are selected. Let's say you want to replace the last transition, and by mistake, you haven't selected the file. Then let's proceed to the transition collection. Select Horizontal 2 in the Templates window and replace any existing transition. The transitions in this section affect both the left and the right file, unlike the Simple Transitions folder that provides single effects. Now, right-click on the transition and in the Transition tab, two options are available. These options come in handy when you need to quickly open the Templates window and replace it with another transition. So let's replace the transition, for example, with Page Turn and right-click on it. Now the button in the Fade Out section is active, since the transition works only at the end of the left file. You can also reset the transition there or find it in the templates. Then we proceed to fade in. This transition will be at the right file. Select the Set Last Used option, and let's see the result of the page turning effect. This way, you can create your own combinations of transitions. But in order to add any new transition for the right file, let's take a look at the Basic Effects window. Basic Effects window. The Basic Effects window appears when you click on the transition area. It can also be reached on the ribbon on the View tab. But if this button is disabled, the window is already opened. There you can see the transitions applied to the selected file. Note that this is the file and not the transition area. For example, let's select a file that has a transition at the beginning and at the end. In the Basic Effects window, you can see the transitions on the left and right and its duration. Here you can also delete any of them by clicking on the cross. In this window, you can also transfer transitions from the Templates window. This is handy when you need to create complex transitions and use, for example, two different transitions. The Use Max Duration option is also available in this window. It allows you to limit the length of the transition to no more than the set value. So the transition will not be longer than 1 second. Let's try to move any border of the transition, and the duration immediately decreases to 1 second. We can edit its duration in the range from 0 to 1 second, and the program will not let you create a transition longer than 1 second. If you need to delete a transition, just move the border without pressing the Alt key. Limitations. A quick note on limitations. Cutting and splitting tools cannot be used within transition areas, so an error message will appear automatically when you try to do this. Also, you cannot use Set Block Order and Set Order with Offset tools. Using them with transitions automatically removes the transition. Also note that changing the speed also removes the transition. If you need to slow down a section of the video, first use the Alt key to move the file to another layer and change its speed there, and then return to the previous layer with the Alt key pressed. And there you have it! A comprehensive guide to mastering the new transition algorithm in VSDC 9.1. Questions or comments? Drop us a line below and do not forget to subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time!